Wednesday is Veterans Day, and as you might imagine, it has a very special meaning for me. Today, I want you to tell you why. I served in the Air Force for 29 years, and flew combat missions in both the Korea and Vietnam Wars. And in 1966, when I was serving in Vietnam, I was shot down and taken prisoner. I spent nearly 7 years in the Hanoi Hilton, and when I got out, I weighed about 140 pounds. I got through those years by the grace of God, and He gave me all the support I needed in my fellow POWs. Great men like Jerry Denton, Jim Stockdale. We weren't allowed to talk, so the first night in my cell after I got out of the torture room, they taught me the tap code. The three of us did everything we could to fight back against our captors. So we were blacklisted as hardcore resistors. Soon we are moved to the place we called Alcatraz, a POW camp along with eight others. The 11 of us became the Alcatraz gang. There we spent 42 months in solitary confinement with our legs shackled. There was no news from home, and our captors did their best to make us feel forgotten. But my Alcatraz buddies and I were a family. We banded together and encouraged one another and kept each other's spirits up. I still remember one night in particular. I had spent 74 days in leg irons, and it had been a long time since I'd had seen the sky and the sun. I felt finished, but that night a typhoon tore through the city of Hanoi. The floor of my cell filled with water, and I huddled against the wall as far away from the rain as I could. I began to pray as I had never prayed before, and I felt a strange sense of peace in the darkness. The next morning, my cell was flooded with the light of dawn. The storm had stopped. The boards off our window were taken off, and I had an overwhelming sense of the presence of God at that moment. I knew I was going to be all right. And just a few hours later, guards came into my cell and removed my legs from the leg stocks. Telling that story reminds me of something a fellow captive etched on one of the walls, and it read, and I quote, "Freedom has a taste to those who fight and almost die that the protected will never know." You know, freedom isn't free. It has a cost, and that cost is paid first by our veterans and their families, because when one member joins, it's the whole family that serves. When our veterans come home, we should do all we can to make sure they get the care they need when they need it. That is the least we can do. For now, I just want to wish all our servicemen and women a very happy Veterans Day. God bless you all, and God bless America. I salute you.